Hi, my name is Shreya Narayan. I'm an actor. I have also been fortunate enough to be a part of producing a film called Wedding Anniversary. And I also write. I'm very, very, very relieved to say this, that after almost 5 years of writing a novel, I've just completed it. Just a second. Sorry, can I cut it?
Yeah, cut it.
As a child, I always wanted to be an author because we just read. We didn't watch cinema. We just read. Our lives and our houses were full of books. But I saw that in school, how much ever I did well, you know, I tried really hard. I was a topper. I felt very proud of myself that I was doing well, but I was very unhappy. It wasn't me. Something was missing. And the constant in my life has always been exploration. I mean, I want to explore. I want to see what all I can be, what all I can do, or maybe, you know, something is better that I do not know about. And, you know, just to know that hunger that you have and curiosity that you have, I think that led me to theater because I was really searching for something, you know, which would come as a relief. But what theater did was I didn't have to be Shreya Narayan or anybody's daughter or anybody's son. I could just be anyone. I mean, just be, I could be anyone, you know. Are these answers too long?
No, it's fine.
Are you sure?
It's fine. Yeah.
Because these are like...
No. Are you aware of certain stereotypical views that people have? And if you have ever had any personal experience, you know, of that?
Ever? Well, it's every day that, you know, you have to contend with the fact that you're an actor and therefore you are looked at as some bohemian creature who is so easy and can just hop into the bed with you for work. It's okay. I mean, you know, every profession comes with some occupational hazard. I do not say I enjoy this. But the first question, you know, that people ask me, you know, especially when I go to small towns, they have this perverse fascination for this. They ask, have you gone through casting couch? That's the first thing people ask. I mean, the moment they come to know that you are an actor and then they get a few moments alone with you, both men and women, you know, they want to know. Very quietly, very politely, they asked me, "That does it exist?" Yes, it exists. Yes, it exists. And have you gone through it? Yes, if all of us, you know, women, whether I'm an actor or I'm not an actor, we have gone through overtures which are not welcome and which you have to do away with. Have you taken up the offer? No, because of which probably I'm still where I am, because, you know, it can get you somewhere probably. But you also are a person, you know. I'm also a human being. I may be an actor or I may be doing work in the film industry. I'm another professional here. But I'm also also a human being, and I have to live this life in peace. And if you decide to live in peace, you have to really, you know, stay away from those things which can really clog your minds and take off that peace and not let you be a great actor. I'm still looking at the lens, right?
Yeah. While answering the question.
Yeah. Anywhere that you look, women are fighting for a little bit of more, a little bit of breaking of glass ceilings or a little bit of respect, because there is no respect for women. I mean, you are in this time and age also a second class citizen, and you have to understand that these ceilings are there, or these hurdles are there, And still, every girl out there or every woman out there is going out and, you know, trying to find a place for herself. So, is film industry any different from the society? Not at all. Is India a patriarchal society? Yes. Is film industry a patriarchal place? Absolutely. 100%. But are there exceptions? Absolutely. Are the times changing? Yes. Are the times completely going to change in favor of women? Never. But we are going to try. We are not going to stop. Bye.
Thank you for bearing with us.
You are so good looking. Film industry is a safe place for women, because film industry realizes that if you do not have systems in place where women feel safe being there, they will not come and work. I always look for safety first, then I go for scripts and any other thing. Safety for a woman is very important. I mean, I need to feel that I can play my characters without, you know, being in a difficult situation later on. So that's the first thing that I go for. And then other things come. Can you imagine? I mean, that's what, that is what a woman thinks first or a girl thinks first anywhere in this country.
Do you want to sip your
coffee? The penchant of Bollywood to think that I'm not an actor just because I do not have, at the rate of stylist this, at the rate of makeup person this, and at the rate of hairdresser this, written under every photograph of mine, that I am a nobody till I can be marketed and made use of and used to earn, you know, through magazines or other things. What has happened is a system has been established, and it is getting established thanks to all the Hollywood stuff. You know, that's how earlier this system was not there. Now I'm supposed to be this perfectly beautiful creature who wears these beautiful clothes all the time, get my makeup and hair done in different ways, and I have to be at these various events in order to be relevant, in order to be an actor. If I am not those things, I'm not an actor. That is shocking to me. That is commercialization of something which is so important to us, you know. If we did not like art, we wouldn't be here. But to not be considered an artist, to not even being auditioned, you know, for a role, not even being considered for a role, because I'm not always there in your face, I'm not, you know, somebody who is always trying to get marketed. That is something which has very long-term and dangerous consequences for art, which people are not realizing right now. They want to adopt the Hollywood model or whatever models there are in the capitalist world. But these models are not working for anyone all over the world. You have to understand that the kind of... It's shameful for me if I wear something so expensive that can buy food for millions of people. I am not a person in isolation. I am not, art is not in isolation of the people, of things which are happening in the world, of the reality of the world. It's disturbing for me when I see that money being wasted in this way. Now you may ask, how do we know that you know, you are wearing something which is not expensive enough? I don't know. I just feel each one has to ask themselves, you know, that am I going the right way? What is this? What are we like vying for? What is this hurry to make it? And what is this that you are ready to forget every ideal or everything that we stood for, and we actually gained a lot from it. Why are we all believe that in free markets, we all believe in competition, we all believe in these good things, but we also live in times where there's so much of disparity between the haves and haves not that it's mind-blowing, and you just cannot believe it. And at that time, somebody who has it is flaunting it in with so much of elan in a way that can hurt somebody who doesn't even have two meals a day to eat. I think that as artists, you have to consider these things. As artists, you have to remember these things, because art is not in isolation. That's the only thing I can say. Art is not in isolation of the world. It is for this world. It is to make this world a better place.